Okay. Looks like you've got a bit of rivalry going on out there. This is good. Gets people talking about you. Just make sure you outperform them, okay?
Hi, it's Emma. Your qualifying goals came up in the board meeting this morning. Here's what to expect.
The sky is dark and the lights are on. Welcome to qualifying here at the Marina Bay Street Circuit in Singapore. This is the kind of track that eats rear tyres for breakfast, or so I'm told by more experienced drivers than myself.
Well, tyre management is key here, specifically the rears. It's all too easy to overheat and wear the rear tyres if they're punished out of the low-speed corners. Most teams won't be able to avoid some kind of issue here, especially the teams that are running less downforce.
Qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are Perez, Areno and Sebastian Vettel. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself gets underway.
Hi, it's Emma here. Just wanted to let you know what the team are hoping for in the race.
As the sun sets over the South China Sea, the sport that never sleeps is alert and raring to go. Welcome, under the bright lights of the Marina Bay Circuit, to another Singapore Grand Prix. It's a very long, very physical lap, this one, and really there's not much in the way of margin for error. So we have a bit of an endurance race for you tonight. Situated just 88 miles north of the equator, this 3.5 mile circuit is hot, it's humid, and is an incredible test for the drivers as they try to fight their cars around the bumps and in between the barriers. 23 corners take us twice over the bay to complete a single lap of this unique racetrack. The view is spectacular, the heat is unbearable. The race should be incredible. A tough race in store then for our drivers today. So tell me, Anthony Davidson, what will you be looking out for as the cars make their way down into Turn 1?
Well, first of all, let's hope that everyone's well behaved and we can have a nice incident-free start. That initial release is going to be the most interesting thing. The clean side of the grid will be better rubbered in, so keep an eye out for cars over there potentially making their way through.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. Sergio Perez and Force India start on pole position, and a Renault alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Hamilton, Daniel Ricciardo, and Bottas, Hülkenberg, Rosberg, Verstappen, and Roman Grosjean, Magnussen, Raikkonen, Esteban Gutierrez, and Alonso, Wehrlein, Massa, Jenson Button, and Rio Haryanto, Sainz, and Ericsson, Daniel Kvyat, and Felipe Nasser starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track. win then for the Renault team today. Tell me, what was the key to this success?
Well, the safety car completely changed the race, didn't it? It's hard to say exactly what would have happened without it, but there's no question that they came out of that situation in a good position.
As we can see, it's time for the podium, and I can see the Renault team underneath our commentary box going crazy as their drivers walk out. It was a great win, and it means a great deal to this team. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I'm going to go for Marcus Ericsson. He's clearly got a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, and he's matured a lot over the past few seasons, which served him well today.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.